It's Rod with Dead Air. Just wanted to go over the proper assembly video of a mask. So we got our mask tube here, and it does have a front and back, and the threads are cut to a different depth. The back of the can actually has a deeper thread cut than the front of the can does for the cap goes. Now, very important when you're assembling the can that the back cap goes in first, and the reason why is the cap doesn't always tighten up necessarily against the can tube. It actually tightens up against the baffle stack in the tube that compresses the baffle stack, and that's what the can tightens up against. Proper way to assemble this, back cap goes in first. And we don't over tighten the back cap, we just thread it down till it stops, give it a good snug, making sure there's no gap in between the back cap and the tube. Then the baffle stack, you'll want to inspect to make sure that all the keyways are all lined up and that there's no gaps inside the baffles at all. And then you're going to want to put that into the can as one assembly. Otherwise, you'll never get all those keyways lined up. Then the front cap of the can will thread on. And then you snug up the front cap with the tool, and you do want to snug this good and tight to compress that baffle stack and also push that entire stack against the back cap, preventing it from loosening up when you're taking the can apart. So you do want to snug that up good and tight. At that point, the back cap on there is super tight. The front cap on there is tight against that. Thread it onto your gun. It shouldn't come loose. It shouldn't come off when you're unthreading it, but that's the proper way to assemble it. Thank you.